Hey grandkids, let me tell about the time that Tinkle Time took over the United States of America. In the year 2030, an organization by the name of Tinkle Time took over the United States of America. They hated fun and laughter in any way, shape, or form. They wanted to banish it. Now, the United States of America citizens had to live in a world without laughter and where it was non-existent. Allow me to fast forward a little into the year 2052. Our two unsuspecting heroes in this story are me and your Uncle Zach. We had just turned 18 and we were discovering, we want to get out into the world and experience what it's like to be an adult. We had no experience whatsoever, so we headed out into the world and we discovered what laughter was. Let me tell you the story of that story.
Zach, wake up.
Hello?
Hey man, how'd you sleep last night?
Oh, sorry dude. Pretty good.
Yeah. We gotta stop staying up till 3:43 a.m. watching Happy Tree Friends.
Alright, I'm gonna go take a wise.
Alright. Zach, come out of the closet.
All right.
Oh, tight squeeze right there.
Have a cushion.
On my way. You know, I have a feeling that watching Happy Tree Friends every single night till 3:43 a.m. is not the best habit to have.
Well, what else is there to do in this world?
Nothing.
I have an idea. We can make a film.
A film?
Yeah.
We are not cut out for making a film.
Well, you might be right on that one, bro. But, I mean, could just go for a walk.
At 3:43 a.m.?
Why not?
Tonight?
Yeah.
You know I hate walking in the woods past 3:42.
Look, I feel like we have to do this so we can truly experience if it's safe or not. I mean, we've gained a total of 48 pounds over the past 2 hours.
You know what, man? I think you're right.
I know I'm right.
I got a question for you. Do you ever get the feeling like there's more to this life?
I do.
I mean, we spend so much of our time just sitting around complaining about, like, oh, the world around us is cool. The world around us, you know, it might be, like, super awesome out there. But what do we do? Instead of actually going out there and exploring it, we sit around on our butts all day watching Happy Tree Friends riding on my hoverboard in circles. What am I even doing? What am I doing? We need to get out into the world. We really do. We need to explore it. Let's make this world a better place.
Nah. Let's just sit around and play with your hoverboard all day.
No! No, dude. You're missing the point. We have to get out into the world and explore it. Did you not hear what I just said?
I heard it and I honestly agree. Let's just... Okay, we're gonna do my idea. We're gonna go for the woods. We're gonna go for a walk in the woods at 3:43 a.m. then.
Fine.
Don't get scared.
Just be quiet about it, because I'm already getting scared. Are you sure we should do this? I mean, Tinkle Time clearly doesn't want us back here.
Dude, is that a sign that said we weren't supposed to be back here? They'd have it posted, okay? We can do whatever we want and be whoever we want to be out here.
Alright.
Alright. Dude,
I'll follow you.
The one rule I have about this trip is we have to stay safe because I'm getting married next week.
Oh, that's right. That's right, yeah. I'm still pissed about that.
Well, why is that?
Well, I was going to be your best man.
Well, yeah, but... My 10th cousin, Steve Chris, is my best man, remember?
He's not even your cousin.
Dude, just because I met him last week in the toilet paper aisle at the local Coburn's does not mean he's not my cousin. We literally submitted a form on Ancestry.com to prove it, and that comes back in like 3 weeks.
Okay, but cousin means by blood.
Yeah, that's why we're testing it. I mean, fuck, you got me a drum set. How am I supposed to not make him my best man?
Whatever, dude. We've been friends since first grade. That's not my problem.
You're right. It's my wedding.
Yeah.
Plus, my wife says you're kind of a turd, so.
Whatever.
I mean, my future wife.
Whatever, buddy.
So, what do you want to do out here? I mean, we're getting pretty far.
We should go into the woods. Why? But I'm going to follow you because you're the dumb one.
Alright. Let's discover some stuff.
Sam!
Seeking.
Does it really make any sense? So, what happened to you?
I honestly have no memory whatsoever.
Okay, well, I'll just tell you what I saw. You were running, and you just fell.
I mean, no, we must have ended up here, and some monster must have taken my coat, my hat, because that's missing. I don't.
This is weird, dude. Hey,
I agree.
What's this?
Ooh, what's this?
Hold on. I don't know if we want to touch that.
There's nothing to lose.
How? Dude, what if this is like one of those ancient booby traps that the Indians set, where if we pick it up, we'll get shot by like poison darts?
I don't give a.
Sam, buddy, old pal, are you alright?
I feel funny.
Hey, you know we're not allowed to say that word.
What else we're not allowed to talk about?
What?
Your mom.
What?
That's right, you heard it.
What did you even mean by that? Dude, whatever that was.
It just came out, man.
Whatever that was is making you act silly, dude. Shall I touch the scroll also?
Be my guest. I'm Trippin'.
Nice to meet you, Trippin'. I'm Zach. What was that?
Dude, it must have been that water.
I don't know if that was water. I don't know what that was. I think we need to read the scroll and find out.
We gotta read this thing.
Look here. Laughter can boost the immune system, relax muscles, aid circulation, and even protect against heart disease? It also enriches social experiences and mental health.
What?
Can relieve anxiety, release tension, and improve mood.
What's laughter and... What is the scroll, man?
Let's keep reading. Unroll it. No, here we go.
If the frontal lobe finds something funny, it lets the effects of that humor proceed, and then it sends out an electrical wave through the cerebral cortex.
There you go.
And from there, the rest of our body responds with surprise, delight, and laughter. The results can be anything from a mild chuckle to an all-out belly laugh.
What's delight?
Well, I think I have an idea, just like a rough idea.
Okay.
Let me put into a sentence for you. It's dark in here, turn on the light.
Wait!
Dude, that's a laugh!
That's definitely
a laugh. I like that.
Yeah, me too, Sammy.
Now let's find a way out of here.
Dude, there's a door right here.
Dude, we're back in your house.
I didn't even know there was a door there.
What did you do?
Let's go back in my room.
This newfound power we have, we need to get this out into the world.
I completely agree, but how are we going to do that?
Well, it's the one way we can get our word across to everyone.
Dude, Twitter.
Oh my god, I have it. I have Twitter.
I love using technology to solve real world problems.
Yeah, me too. Let me...
Is it almost done?
Yeah, I think we're gonna... Yeah, okay. Alright. Tweet posted. Let's go.
Saw your tweet. So it was you two who unveiled my dirty little secret of laughter.
Yes, that's us. Oh. We know what Tickle Time has been hiding, and we intend on exposing it to the world and letting them know how laughter affects the brain. And who are you?
Mm-hmm. Who am I?
Who are you?
The name's Juggs. Amethyst Napoleon Juggs. The CEO and founder Tickle Time. And the one who will end you guys.
Hey, hey! How can you do this to the people of the United States that you claim to care so much about?
It's easy.
You know, people need 15 to 20 laughs every day just to live their life to the fullest. You're taking that away.
No. My godparents took that away from me when I was just a little scrub nugget on the streets of Memphis. If I can't laugh, no one can.
No! That's how everyone has been living. How everyone in this once great nation has been living. You see us? We're gonna end this dictatorship that you've bestowed upon our once great nation. And I need to do this for my future wife and any future pet children I may have, including my pet lizard, Leroy Jenkins.
I love Leroy.
Silence, peasants. Hand over that ancient, old-looking paper.
It's called a scroll.
That's facts.
You can't stop Jugs.
Oh. Dude, Zach, I have Jugs.
Dude, you have Jugs.
What is this ruckus? And what's so funny?
Oh, nothing. Look, we're just glowing with laughter. Don't you know that laughter releases something called beta endorphins? It lessens depression, which is obviously a great thing. Obviously. It also releases growth hormones to keep you growing. Keep your immune system healthy. Sometimes when you're laughing, it leads to your blood vessels increasing in size, which can help prevent blood clots and even future issues in the arteries.
Sorry, Zach. I just thought that was so boring.
Yeah, okay. It's science, dude. Science of the brain.
Science is lame. Feel me, for I am Master Jugs, CEO of Tickle...
Prepare to die.
Run, 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 run.
And it looks like the Houston Texans are going to the Super Bowl for the first time in 78 years. Hold on. Are you serious? Breaking news, folks. The Tickle Time CEO, Amethyst Napoleon Jugs, has just been killed. This is not a joke. Two 18-year-old heroes have come in and taken out the Tickle Time CEO. I cannot believe this. Oh, man. Dante, bring me my coffee.
Coming, sir. Here you go.
Oh, Dante, you son of a bitch.
Build whatever meal you want with favorites on McDonald's new $1, $2, $3
menu. You don't know where he went? Oh, we're on the air. Well, we're back, and we're going to go live to the scene of Zach and Sam.
Sir, you're making me joke.
We're going to go back to the scene of Zach and Sam. And we're going to have a live interview with them to see what it's like being the new heroes of the world.
How's it going, guys? I'm Sam.
I'm Zach. Thank you guys for coming out on such short notice, because that means a lot to us.
And we've been through a lot these past few days. We just want to share with you guys what we have learned through our experience.
It's been crazy, so
take it away.
Let's just get it started. So let me show you first what you guys have been missing. So the path of neuronal activity, while laughing, goes a little something like this. So first, it goes through the frontal lobe, and that processes the information you took in. And then the supplementary motor area, which is near the frontal lobe, it takes in the learned experiences, and it taps into those, and then it directs the motor activities associated with laughing from those learned experiences.
And the brain also receives an array of endorphins, serotonin, and dopamine. So jokes work because of the surprise aspect to them. And here's the process of laughing, Zach.
So the frontal lobe searches with pattern recognition, and the punchline then shifts our brain into processing an emotional response. Then the response is relevance checked, and if the prefrontal cortex deems it worthy, it dedicates way more processing power to it, therefore making us laugh.
Alright guys, and if the information remains relevant through the rest of the joke, the brain shifts the response to the pleasure and reward center, which then triggers laughter. The left side of the brain analyzes the joke, and the frontal lobe becomes super active, Brainwave activity goes crazy when the joke gets realized by the brain and it sends a message to the rest of the body.
That's right, Sam. Now, here's the fun part for you guys. It's time to exercise our frontal lobes a little bit because we want you guys to be able to laugh too, because if it's just us laughing, that's nowhere near as fun.
Not as fun.
Anyway, we've created a new thing called dad jokes.
Dad jokes.
We're going to show some to you right now.
Show some to you right now.
That's what we're doing. So, I recently figured out why nurses carry red crayons around. In case they have to draw blood.
Okay. Tough crowd. All
right.
I'll give it a shot.
Go ahead.
This morning I saw the milkman drinking a sip of my milk before leaving it on the front of my door. How dare you?
Now we're cooking. What rhymes with orange?
No, it doesn't.
Anyway, I bet my butcher that he could reach the meat on the top shelf. He's like, I'm not gonna bet with you. The stakes are too high.
What happens when you go to the bathroom in France? European.
I have this terrible disease where I can't stop telling airport jokes. My doctor says it's terminal.
Hey, Dad, can you tell me what a solar eclipse is? No, son.
My therapist told me I have trouble interpreting social cues. I'm pretty sure she's in love with me.